Traefik is a reverse proxy and TLS termination proxy we'll use. It can also be used as a load balancer. It is probably the most important service in this setup because it will be the only way to access any HTTP service inside this network. We'll deploy it as a Docker container, bind ports 80 and 443, and then route all HTTP traffic to the appropriate service, be it another Docker container or LXC. Let's go back to the drawing to explain that in a bit more detail. As I said, we'll deploy traffic as a Docker container. If you are wondering how will something inside a Docker container accept packets coming to the public interface, you should probably rewatch the Docker videos. In short, when you run a container, you can map port on the host, in my case this VPS, to the port inside the container. So all we need to do is map both port 80 and port 443. That way, when something comes to the public interface on either of those ports, it will be forwarded to the traffic container. Nice thing with Docker is that it will automatically add any necessary firewall rules. With port mappings in place, how will a network packet reach Zulip, for example? If someone asks for https://zulip.dio-p.com, it will first resolve to the public IP of this VPS. HTTP request will come to this interface on port 443, it will be routed to traffic, and then what? That's where traffic providers come into play, and in case of Linux containers, file provider. We'll have a configuration file, which traffic will read, and that file will tell it that when something asks for zulip.dio-p.com, traffic should route that to the Zulip LXC. In case traffic needs to route something to some other Docker container, e.g. GitLab after we deploy it, it's even easier. In that case, we'll use a Docker provider. For that to work, we'll have to run a Docker container with some additional labels. You should read the documentation on those, but I'll talk more about them later. Traffic will talk with Docker Engine and monitor for those labels. When it finds one of interest, it will add that information to its config, and it will then know how to handle those packets and deliver them to their destination. Don't panic, we'll go one step at a time.